with Butterflies and Angels. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about why Butterflies and Angels. Why did I choose that name and what is that all about? Well, when I was a little girl, I used to play out in the sheets. My mom would wash the sheets and hang them out to dry on the clothesline. And I used to love to run through the sheets and play with them. And I had some imaginary friends, Dodo and Delos, who lived in the tree in my front yard. And we also had in our yard, which was almost an acre long, the one side was completely covered with, we called them lilac bushes, but they were really trees because they were like 15 feet tall. And I used to play hide and seek with Dodo and Delos in the lavender bushes, trees, whatever you want to call them. And I loved the smell of the lilacs. And I loved playing with them. And I loved playing with them so much that pretty soon when my cousins would come over, they would be playing with them as well. Well, I personally believe that when children have imaginary friends, it's actually their guardian angels that are able to talk to them and play with them. And they continue to be with us for the rest of our lives. And, you know, some children just remember, and some children are a little more able to see, especially if they have some gifts there. And so, they actually are able to play with them because they don't have all the resistance that we as adults have. So that's kind of where that part started. And then as I was growing up, I noticed that I had some gifts. Now, I was raised independent fundamental Baptist. And so my church absolutely did not believe in most of the gifts that I have and anything to do with that. But I also had some other people in my family that had the same gifts. And even at 6 years old, I would notice the phone would ring and I would know who was calling before it was answered and things like that. And I would think about something and a second later it would happen. And then one night I actually realized that there was something very different about me, because we had a friend from church. She was very, very sick. And we had been praying for this lady, holding prayer vigils at church and so on and so forth. And I was asleep one night and I opened my eyes and she came out at me from the wall and scared the crap out of me, obviously. Well, the next morning my mom got a phone call and she actually had passed away. And so that really scared me, and I told my mom about it, and she was really concerned and worried that I might get possessed and things of that nature. And so I've had to come a long way in my journey and accept different beliefs. My father actually told me, because he was gifted in many ways too. He was not a medium, but he was very psychic. And he believes, as I believe, it's a gift from God, just like anything else, like being able to play the guitar or to be able to sing or write or draw. It's a gift, and God gives us a gift for a reason, for it to be used. And so I have throughout my life stayed very close to God, and I do take precautions because I know that there are negative and bad energies out there and that you do have to shield yourself and be careful. And we'll talk about all those kinds of things on this channel as we go through. But I just wanted to give you a little bit of how that all came about for me. So my biggest thing was I didn't want to see. And I had some other experiences, and I won't bore you with all of that. I'm actually writing a book about it, and that'll be out one day, and you can read more about it once that's released if you're interested. But I came to realize that it was a gift from God and that I should be using it, and that there were things that I could learn to do to protect myself and to help myself to have less anxiety and things of that nature. But I still did not love the idea of talking to dead people. It scared the crap out of me. I didn't want to see them, and that I've set ground rules. I might see a shadow out of my corner of my eye, or I might see something in my mind's eye, but I don't physically see them standing there, because that is just too much for me. I don't like that. And I had pushed the medium side away and away and away, although I did work with the other gifts somewhat. And then in 2013, I lost my oldest daughter in a moped accident. And she was 21, and she also was gifted, and she was a medium. And all of my children have different gifts, but she understood. And I really wanted to talk to her and wanted to communicate with her. So I learned more about protecting myself and studied and read everything I could about it, took classes and did things, because I have found what a gift and what a comforting relief it is to be able to communicate with someone that has transitioned. And, you know, it's very comforting that when they can give you signs and messages and let you know that they're still around. Because in every single reading I've ever done, the number one point that they want to get across to us is that they are still around. They still see what's happening and they still care about us. The love never goes away and their energy never dies. So that's a little bit about me and my channel. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, I would like for you to please give me a like. That does help the algorithms. And subscribe and hit the bell so you'll know when I have more videos like this for you. And I'll be posting all kinds of videos about different things, how to shield yourself, how to do, you know, different things. And I think it will be a good time for all of us. So please be sure to subscribe. And I thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.